In this video, I'm going to show you how to integrate a Neos smart camera into Home Assistant. Make sure you stick around, and if you like what you see, hit the subscribe button below and keep an eye out for more videos. Hi, I'm Will from Will Surridge Tech. And today we're going to integrate a Neos smart camera into Home Assistant. If you haven't already, make sure you check out part one of this series where I show you how to flash the Neos camera with custom Defang firmware. So let's get going. So we have a Neos camera, we've removed all the cloud rubbish from it and we're now running it on custom Defang firmware, which is great. But what we want to do is be able to see it and control it from within Home Assistant. Viewing is easy. We're going to make use of the RTSP feed. But to make it work, we're going to need to change a few settings. So let's head over to the interface for the camera. In here, we're going to want to change our bitrate to 500, our video size to 1280 by 720, and our video mode to VBR. We're also going to want to copy the RTSP stream URL here so we can paste it into Home Assistant later on. If we head over to Home Assistant, we can add a new camera. As usual, I've got mine referenced in a separate folder, but you can add them to the main config file if you prefer. What we're going to do is add a generic camera. We can name it, add the username and password. By default, these are root and iSmart12, but you may have already changed it in the camera interface. We add basic authentication, add a still image URL, and a stream URL. The stream URL is the RTSP stream that we copied from our camera interface. We set the frame rate to 5, verify SSL to false, and the scan interval to 5. Now some of these functions relate to the still image URL as opposed to the RTSP feed, but we may find we want to use the still image later on. We now need to get our still image URL, so we head back over to the camera interface, and under the video settings, there's a section that says video test. We press get image, and it'll open our new window with an image of the camera. We copy the URL of this window and we paste this into our still image URL in Home Assistant. Once that's done, we can save, check our config and restart Home Assistant. Once it's restarted, our new camera entity should appear. You might find that the feed is a bit slow to load. This could just be the first time it loads, but if it's happening every time, then you may want to change your bitrate and video size back in the camera settings. You can also change the video mode. But I'm not really sure what each of them does. If you know, please let me know in the comments below. The preload stream function is great if you're running on a high-powered computer because it will preload the stream for you so you don't have to wait for its buffer every time you click on it. If you're running on a weaker computer, like a Raspberry Pi, then I recommend you don't do this, or at least don't do it on too many cameras. If you find that your stream is great, then you can always increase the bitrate and increase the video size to get a better quality stream. If not, then you keep fiddling until you get a good enough stream for you. I found that these settings work really well for my front door camera, but don't seem to be working as well for this camera. If, however, you're finding that the RTSP feed is just absolutely useless and won't load for you and doesn't work, then you can always use the still image URL instead. Instead of getting live motion with a continuous video stream, you just get the single snapshot image and it'll refresh that every second or so. This isn't continuous motion, but it should be enough to see what's going on or see whether there is actually someone at your front door or not. To do this, we need to comment out the RTSP stream from our camera configuration file and restart Home Assistant. Now we can move on to using MQTT to control the camera and its features. I won't go into detail of setting up an MQTT broker, but I'm using the Mosquito broker in the add-on store. To do this, we're going to need to change some configuration files, and we're going to do that by SSHing into our camera. So we open up a command line, and we type SSH root at, and then the IP address of your camera. So SSH root at 192.168.0.142 in my case. It's going to ask for a password. The default password is iSmart12. We now need to go cd dot dot, and then cd system slash SD card. If you type ls, you should see a list of all the files in this folder. In there, there should be a file called mqtt.conf.2. MQTT.dist. We're going to copy this to create an MQTT.conf file. So we use the command cp space MQTT.conf.dist space MQTT.conf. Once copied, we're going to need to edit it. To do that, we type vi space MQTT.conf. We then type I to enter edit mode, and then we need to add the username, password, and host IP address of our broker. So for me, that's the IP address of my home assistant setup. We can then change the location and device name to what we want to appear as the topic of our MQTT later. So mine's going to be camera slash dining room. We can scroll down and we need to uncomment the auto discovery for home assistant. That means it'll automatically pop up and we don't need to go and find it ourselves. We're also going to change the light sensor to HW. That means it's going to use the built-in LDR to detect the light levels, as opposed to trying to figure it out using the image and software-based problems instead. Once we're happy, we need to save it and exit. So we hit escape, hit colon, WQ, enter. Once happy, we can close the terminal window and head back to our camera interface. We're going to want to restart the camera here and then head into services and scroll down, and then we want to turn on MQTT status and MQTT command. We're also going to want these to auto-run, so they automatically happen every time you restart the camera. Now we can head over to the logs file of our MQTT broker, and we can see there's been a new connection from this camera. If that hasn't happened, then you may need to restart your MQTT broker or your camera to get it to appear. Once it appears, you can head over to your integrations, and you'll see a new device will be listed. If we click through, we can see all sorts of levels of control now, from LED control to motion detection, from recording to night mode. I won't go into too much detail about motion detection, but you can see that there's a motion detection sensor which will be clear or detected, and then there's a snapshot of the last motion event, which you can make use of in your integrations and your automations. I was really hoping I'd be able to show you how to get your camera stream onto your TV. Unfortunately, Google Cast doesn't seem to accept RTSP streams. If you know a workaround for this and how to get your camera stream onto your TV, then please let me know in the comments below, as it would be great to know. But ignoring that, we do have a Neos camera integrated into Home Assistant. Make sure you click subscribe below and hit the bell icon to find out more about my smart tech and how you can build yourself the ultimate smart home.